The Jacinto 7 processors are designed for automotive safety. Aside from the safety MCU domain, which was previously mentioned, additional hardware diagnostics and monitoring features are present in the main domain. In fact, the SoC architecture was designed from the bottom up with safety in mind. So these safety-related features permeate the entire architecture. In this section, I will give an overview of the safety MCU features and general safety features implemented across the device, which can facilitate system designs for safety levels up to ASIL-D systems. The Jacinto 7 safety MCU domain is designed to operate in isolation from the rest of the SoC device, which we will refer to as the main domain. This safety MCU is designed to target ASIL-D system designs. It contains a lockstep R5 processor, which acts as the primary safety master in the system, as well as the DMSC M3, which manages device configuration, and a full set of peripherals and DMA. The domain has isolated clocks, resets, and voltage supplies, such that it can operate even if the main domain has become corrupt or is in an invalid voltage state. The R5 can utilize a local 1 MB RAM for program and data space, or it can extend the program space to an external flash via the external flash controller, which also supports inline ECC and other safety features. Voltage domain monitors, self-test, and other diagnostics are all managed from the safety MCU R5. These are covered in the subsequent slide. Since data exchange between the two domains may be necessary for DMSC requests or peripheral or flash memory sharing, there are several options of varying levels of isolation. These options include a full high-performance parallel bus with a timeout gasket to protect the safety MCU from any hang on the main domain side, or, for an even higher level of isolation, a spy-to-spy interface can further decouple the two domains, similar to how an external MCU would behave. The safety MCU is also designed to work in conjunction with the safety features implemented on the TI Power Management ICs, or PMICs, to maintain voltage isolation and provide comprehensive monitoring of both the SoC and the PMIC in a safe automotive system. The full safety MCU system allows the possibility to eliminate an external micro in the system, which saves system costs while also providing added flexibility and still meeting system safety goals. As mentioned previously, there are many safety features implemented throughout the Jacinto 7 architecture which can be leveraged to achieve the desired safety level in automotive systems. This slide gives a high-level summary of some of these features. Lockstep R5 cores are available in both the main domain and the safety MCU domain. Multiple heterogeneous cores can be leveraged to cross-check critical safety-related calculations. Windowed watchdog timers are available on all the CPUs to monitor execution flow. The interconnect or bus fabric throughout the safety MCU and in some derivatives on a portion of the main fabric has additional redundancy and error correction for robust operation. The DMA and data movement IP throughout the architecture include ECC and protection of critical state for robustness and address containment for isolation. Most memories across the device and within the IPs contain ECC or parity. Peripheral IPs also follow development flows required for safety. Key features are available on the graphics and communication IPs, which support data checking and isolation within these IPs and can be leveraged for safe system design. Secure authentication and task isolation protect system robustness in mixed security environments. A broad range of diagnostic monitors located in both the safety MCU domain and the main domains can be leveraged to achieve system safety goals. These include voltage, temperature, and clock monitors, as well as dedicated DMAs to calculate CRC to check for data correctness. These DMAs are in parallel to the functional DMAs described in the data movement section. Programmable error signal monitors, or ESMs, in both the main and the MCU domains combine all errors and interrupt the safety processor in case of error. They may also be configured to directly indicate errors to the external system through I/O to enter safe mode. Built-in self-test hardware is also accessible for key IPs and memories. These can be run at boot or for some IP at runtime to check for memory or logic faults before use. The safety MCU domain self-tests can optionally run automatically at power on at a fast rate to meet automotive boot time goals. Flexible ADC and external power monitors are also available to monitor external system components.
Thank you for watching this training. For more information, refer to the links shown. For questions about this training, go to the processor forums at ede.ti.com.